Hello and welcome to ADHD Support Talk Radio. This is your host, Tara McGillicuddy. I'm an adult ADHD productivity coach, and I'm also the founder and director of addclasses.com. And at addclasses.com, we provide virtual support and education to people affected by ADD and ADHD. We offer free teleseminars. We have an extensive ADD audio library with more than 100 courses. And we also offer more in-depth support programs. And you can learn more about ADD Class by going addclasses.com, by going to the website, www.addclasses.com. And with that, I would like to welcome back Alan Brown to ADHD Support Talk Radio. I know Alan was on a couple years ago, and he has agreed to return. And in just a moment, we're going to be talking about some of the things that actually make ADD and ADHD worse. So welcome back, Alan.
Thanks, Tara. It's great to be here again.
Okay. Before we start talking about some of the things that make ADHD worse, can you let our listeners know a bit about yourself? Who are you and helping? Who are you in relationship to helping people affected by ADD and ADHD? And also, how can they get in touch with you after the show is over?
Yep, we'll do. Well, I'm an executive, an entrepreneur, and a coach, and I created the ADD Crusher videos and tools for teens and adults with ADHD. And the video part is important because when I was diagnosed late in life after a lot of kind of just floundering around, underachievement, I was actually kind of a drunk and a junkie for a while. Not kind of, really was. And once I got kind of cleaned up and finally got my diagnosis at the age of 36, I went out and bought books and then realized, oh, that's right, I really suck at reading, which a lot of ADDers do. You know, 30% of ADDers are dyslexic, and most of the other 70% really don't like reading. So I couldn't kind of understand why there wasn't more multimedia, opportunities to learn solutions. So that's why I created the videos. And you can find the videos at addcrusher.com. You can preview them there and also on our YouTube channel. And also in there, sign up for the free ebook, which is appropriately titled, given our topic today, 5 Things You're Doing Every Day That Make Your ADHD Worse. And we'll include you in our very informative and fun newsletter. And also I want to mention that we have a promo coupon that if you do end up buying anything on the site, use promo code TARAMC, as in Tara McGillicuddy, TARAMC, and that'll yield you 15% savings on any purchases you make. So that's me, and that's ADD Crusher.
Oh, great. No, and you are very active in the ADHD community, and I mean, I think you came on the scene about 2 years ago, and very dedicated, great stuff. Definitely take a look at addcrusher.com, and the videos are excellent. I mean, I think it's great that you did a video because, like you said, especially when you got diagnosed, you know, going back over a decade ago or whatever it was, there wasn't a lot of multimedia. There was mostly books, so it's great, and they're easy to watch, and definitely they keep the attention of somebody with ADHD, so I highly recommend the videos.
Thanks, Tara.
So with that, I guess we can get started talking about some of the things that actually make ADD worse. So where should we begin with that, Alan?
Well, you know, whenever I think about this topic, I think about the fact that, you know, ADDers are at a disadvantage from the get-go, right? So we really shouldn't be doing anything that makes our ADHD worse, and yet we do. Mm-hmm. You know, we do things to ourselves or we don't do things for ourselves that make our ADHD worse or at least seem worse. And so I want to share a handful of those things. There are many. I've got a list. I do a full presentation that I've done at webinars and at conferences that's called 10 Things You're Doing Every Day That Make Your ADHD Worse. But given the time that we have today and just to kind of give you a taste of it, we're just going to share a few. But it's something that we have the power to recognize and alter.
So what is the first one?
Well, the first one is sugar.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you folks who have been, you know, spending time at ADClass.com or living with ADHD or other forums and just kind of being aware of some of the dialogue that's going on about ADHD, you probably know that diet is an important factor in this. And if you had to just pick out one thing in a diet that makes your ADHD worse, it's sugar.
Yep.
And the reason for that is that sugar gives you a quick rush of brain energy. Our brain is fueled by glucose, and when we're eating too much sugar, we fizzle out. We get this high, and then we just crash out. You've heard of a sugar crash, and the problem is that ADDers tend to walk around. I know so many people, for instance, in the advertising business, which is where I'm from originally, who walk around with a can of Mountain Dew or a Pepsi or some other sugary drink or even Gatorade, which has a lot of sugar, and think that it's fuel, but it's really short-term fuel. And even on top of that and related to sugar are simple carbohydrates, which when you eat them turn into sugar. And so we are walking around eating donuts for breakfast or croissants for breakfast instead of a protein breakfast. And this is just murder on us. And, you know, for instance, in when I was in the ad business early on, and it was before I was diagnosed, I was eating a croissant with butter every morning and a sugary coffee. And I just couldn't figure out why my brain would just stop at 9:35 a.m., you know. And later on, of course, I figured it out. But this is something that we all do too much, it's definitely a self-inflicted wound.
Yeah, and just in general, we're learning more and more that sugar is bad for everyone. I actually just started recently reading Dr. John Rady's new book, Go Wild, and there's a whole section in there about sugar and carbohydrates and how it's done so much damage to our society and our culture. Sugar, yeah, it makes ADHD worse. I think it makes, you know, life worse for everybody, but then ADHD, it like doubles, triples it, quadruples it. So
yeah, and you're so right. The nutrition experts are now talking about the fact that a calorie is not a calorie. You know, there are different calories, and fat calories are actually not as bad as sugar calories. And you're absolutely right. They're identifying sugar as being this thing that is not only bad for our brains, but really bad for our bodies over the long haul. So.
But sugar is so easy to eat. I mean, you come from marketing, so you know. I mean, people, they do the marketing. It's packaged. It's easy. And not just the sugar, you know, the bad carbs. So it takes some work to get sugar out of your system and, you know, replace it with protein. Not a ton of work, but, you know, it's a little bit more challenging to have protein for breakfast or throughout the day.
Yeah, and making it worse is there's a lot of hidden sugar, quote unquote hidden sugar. It's not hidden if you read the labels, but you know, the nutrition labels. But you know, there are these health drinks, quote unquote healthy juices or healthy fruit drinks, and those have tons and tons of sugar, including a lot of protein drinks and protein snacks. That, you know, if you actually look at the labels, you'll see that there might be 19 grams of sugar to 5 grams of protein. And that's, again, we think that we're feeding our brain properly there because we do get a little burst of energy out of it, but it's not a sustained energy at all.
That's great that you brought up the sugar. What is the next thing that a lot of us do to make ADHD worse?
Well, this is a biggie, and, you know, it's simply the notion of worry. And, you know, you think about the ADHD mind, which is constantly churning. We're constantly going. We're always thinking of the next thing. You know, we're daydreaming, we're often panicking, we're anxious about things, etc. And if we actually stop to listen to that inner dialogue, we find that a lot of it, I don't know if it's the majority, but it depends on who you are, but it can be a majority of that kind of cacophony that's going on in your mind is worry. You're worried about what happened in the past. You're worried about what's going to happen in the future, and particularly for ADDers who are often finding themselves in a state of overwhelm. They're always stressed. And there's a wonderful quote I've forgotten the name of this sage, but the quote goes, "Worry does not empty tomorrow of its sorrows. It empties today of its strengths." And I think that a lot of ADDers are making their ADHD worse by allowing so much worry to occupy their precious mental space, especially when, you know, we have, you know, we are easily mentally fatigued and we don't have, you know, the same amount of a fuel tank, so to speak, as the regular Joe or Jane has. And so we have to be much more careful about what we're going to spend our time thinking. Worry is one of these things that we just do way, way too much of. And if you can just start to be more conscious of what your thoughts are. Just be, as they say in the, you know, the Eastern realm, you know, be the witness to your own thoughts.
Yeah.
And start to listen for worry and start to listen for thoughts about the past and the future that really aren't material to what you happen to be working on now. And you can actually free up a lot of energy by just being, you know, more conscious of it.
Yeah, and I admit I'm a worrier. I'm not as much of a worrier as I, you know, was in the past, but it's tough to get out of that mindset. You can get out of it or lessen it and start thinking more positive thoughts, but I know Dr. Daniel Amen years ago, you know, one of his first books about ADD, was talking about the automatic negative thoughts like worry, anger, the negative thoughts. It's almost like a way of self-medicating. So some of us who aren't, you know, treating our ADHD as best as we could, the worrying stimulates the brain, but it does make things worse.
Yeah, and you know, you touched on a point there also that, you know, our natural evolutionary inclination is to be negative, is to view things slightly negatively, because that's what kept us from walking out of the cave and getting eaten by a, you know, a saber-toothed tiger. Having that skepticism about things and feeling that, you know, viewing things as just being a little bit more negative than they necessarily need to be. But we don't live in caves anymore, and we still have that automatic inclination to kind of, and especially for ADDers, the automatic inclination to kind of portray things in the negative, view things in the negative, not least of which is viewing ourselves in the negative, which, you know, I know, you know, Tara, you and I could go on about negative self-talk and the destructive powers of that, but, you know, just worry alone is this huge waste of energy, and it in effect makes your ADHD worse.
Well, the media perpetuates it. I mean, just you turn on the news, you turn on a TV show, and it's all negativity. It makes you worry worse. And I actually just canceled my cable TV yesterday. I hadn't watched TV in a few days, and I'm like, you know what? Every time I turn on, that I notice that I start thinking negative thoughts, and it's a bad mindset. And I got to the point where I'm like, you know, it's not worth the money I'm paying. You know, so, I mean, it, just becoming aware of worry and the things that trigger the worry and the negative thoughts. And for me, it's TV. It's cable TV.
Well, I have to tip my hat to you. I mean, that's a pretty awesome move. You know, going ahead and canceling the cable thing. I have, in the last year in particular, have just, because I'm kind of a news hound. My family is all in the news business, so I feel like it's my obligation to keep up on news. But really, it's true. When you sit down and watch a news program or just most of the stuff that's on, it's so negative. There's just, you know, dramas are about murder, and the news is about how, you know, these guys are idiots, no, those guys are idiots, and then this horrible thing is happening in Syria or whatever. You know, it really is a pretty negative picture that is painted around us. That is a really big point that you make. And it's a great segue into another thing that we do that makes our ADHD worse, which is what Dr. Ed Halliwell calls screen sucking.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we spend way too much time on screens.
Yep.
And it's not just the TV screen. You know, speaking of TV, you know, the 3 hours that the average American spends watching TV are really 3 hours wasted. And when ADDers are walking around, you know, saying, I just don't have time to do all the stuff that I've been assigned to do, or I always feel overwhelmed, and then so many of us sit down and watched an hour or two or three or more hours of TV, and it's kind of like, wait a minute, you know, you know, how can you kind of get off complaining? And then, you know, be on the TV screen is, of course, our iPhones or our smartphones and our iPads and our video games and all that stuff. So screen sucking is another way that we, in effect, make our own ADHD worse. Again, hats off to you for shutting down the cable.
Oh, yeah, I still have Netflix and all that. It's not like I'm going to totally not watch TV again, but it's just flipping through. And you talked about the news. I became a news junkie. If something bad happened, I'd be on there. And, yeah, so we'll see. Hopefully it'll last. Yeah, so, all right, we talked about sugar, worry, screen sucking. What do you think is something else that's important to talk about today?
Well, you know, multitasking is another big one that makes things worse for us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there are two really important principles that I tell everyone when it comes to multitasking, and the first one is that multitasking is for suckers, you know. And I know you know about this, the research that has been done on multitasking. Yale was where the seminal research was done, and it just simply says that even the best multitaskers stink at multitasking.
Yes, we
and
do.
And that no one can, you know, effectively execute multiple tasks versus how effective they can be by just doing the one task. Now, that said, the second important thing is that we ADDers have difficulty staying focused on the one task, right?
Yeah.
Because we, unlike regular people who prioritize things based on what's most important, makes sense, we prioritize things based on what is most interesting at the moment. And that's the classic squirrel thing, right? I mean, it's just like the oldest ADHD joke in the world. But, you know, think about it. You sit down to do a task like a tough email or writing an article or, you know, Tara, you've got to sit down and do some work around some of the marketing from one of your many, many media properties in your empire. Or, you know, just thinking about starting to do the laundry or go and clean the garage.
Mm-hmm.
And immediately things start to come into your mind and in your mind's eye and also into your line of sight that tempt you. And we look for those things to, hey, come and rescue me from this hard task. Oh, let me check my email again. Let me check my Facebook again. Let me check my Instagram. Oh, you know what? I got to check the mail again. Or, oh, someone's calling me. Let me answer this phone, even though it's not urgent and has nothing to do with what you're trying to get done. That is the curse of multitasking. And, you know, the more we can recognize that this is a really, it's a fool's errand, and that even although it does feel good in a way to, well, I'm sitting here, I have to do this article, or I have to prepare for my call with Tara, but let me just go check this thing, or let me watch that YouTube video, or let me call so-and-so. All this stuff is self-defeating. And it makes our ADHD world worse than it needs to be.
It does. And it feels so much better to get that one project or task completed and out of the way. And, I mean, I was just trying to get a bunch of things done today, and I just noticed I had, like, 10 tabs open on my browser, and I'm, like, going in circles, and I'm, like, and I had to stop myself and say, I'm going to work on this thing and get it done, and I'm not moving on. And it wasn't even, it was something that probably took 10 minutes. It should have taken 10 minutes if I stuck with it for 10 minutes. But it's amazing how the ADD mind works and the things that get your attention, and you just move on to it unless you become aware that, okay, multitasking is not a good idea.
I tell you, the tabs on a browser and on a computer is a great metaphor, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, you talk about how you ended up having 10 tabs open. That is, in effect, what we end up doing when we're, you know, we've got stickies all over the place, or we started this and we started that and we started that. And what happens, bringing it back to the literal example of the tabs on your browser, is you look at all those tabs and you go, oh, my God, this is overwhelming. I don't know which one to do. And you end up bouncing back and forth between them and not being able to knock any of them out.
Yeah.
That is, you know, the end result of multitasking, is that you're not able to get any of the
And then the computer starts running slow because, of course, it's not just the browser I have open. It's all the other programs, which is definitely connected. You know, it's a metaphor to the ADD mind that when you have so many things going, you get overwhelmed and your brain doesn't work as well as it could be working.
I'll tell you, I'm writing this down right now. That it's such a wonderful metaphor for the ADHD mind is these tabs that are open and the different apps that are open.
Yeah.
So forgive me for pausing while everyone's listening here. I just have to write this down. That's my little trick. And by the way, I was going to say it's my little trick. I just have to write things down right now when I think of them. But, you know, that speaking of tricks, that is one of the things that we teach in ADD Crusher videos. It's actually video 2, way 8. We teach a very powerful mind hack for how to stop multitasking and how to, when you pick one task, you know, you just, there's a trick for staying on that task. And it's very doable and it's very liberating. And of all the, I teach a lot of Zen brain hacks. Of all the Zen brain hacks that I teach, that is responsible for probably 20% of my overall productivity in life generally. I'm not exaggerating. It's just.
I'll have to watch that video again because I definitely can use some support with that.
Yeah, and I'm sure that we have talked about this hack at one time or another, but you'll remember it the moment you see it. It's way 8 in video too. It's called Do What You're Doing Now. But yeah, multitasking is an absolute curse, and it's something that we do more than anybody else, and it makes our ADHD worse than it needs to be.
I think we have time for one more thing we can talk about that makes ADHD worse.
Well, you know, we started out with a fundamental, which is diet, right? And mm-hmm. and at the other kind of side of that fundamental package is crappy sleep.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as you know, Tara, ADHD is often misdiagnosed because there's an underlying sleep deprivation under there that is showing up like ADHD. So you can imagine, of course, and we all with ADHD, we know that not getting enough sleep or enough quality sleep just makes us have to, you know, we have to drink more coffee, we have to do more of our meds, or we just can't function. So it's kind of obvious that crappy sleep, it makes our ADHD worse.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's important for ADDers to know that this is to some degree unique to us. We actually have, ADDers tend to have dysfunctional circadian clocks. Our circadian rhythm is off. So when the sun has gone down and it is dark out, normal circadian clocks tell the brain, okay, dude, time to go to sleep. And our brains don't always flip that switch. And it's one of the reasons why we often find ourselves wound up late at night. I remember when I was in second, third, fourth grade, up at 1 in the morning, like cleaning my closet or something.
Oh, wow.
Or writing my name over and over again just because I was bored but wired. And then, of course, when Mom is screaming from downstairs the next morning, get up, time to go to school, I'd be like, I'm up. And I'd stick one foot out the covers and stomp it on the floor to sound like I'm up. Do you ever do that trick? I'm up. And then she'd yell back, I know you're just stomping your foot. Get up. But, you know, that's been definitely one of the things that has kind of haunted me all my years. And you have to work, you know, hard at getting good sleep. But it starts with just being aware of how we all typically don't get enough or enough quality sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And know that when we are not doing so, we are making our ADHD much worse than it needs to be.
Yeah. I think the older you get, the less likely you are to function when you get less sleep. Right? You know, when you're like 19 or 20, you could pull a few all-nighters. But like when you start getting in your 30s, 40s, 50s, you really, really need that sleep. And when you add ADHD to it, you really need your sleep.
It is so true. And, you know, we all of us folks, I'm a little older than you, but you hit it on the head. It's like, you know, when you're in your 40s and maybe into your 50s, it's like, wow. Why can't I stay up till 1 in the morning, you know, anymore and get up and go to work and actually function? I used to be able to do that when I was 23. But still, no matter what your age, if you're an adult with ADHD and a teen also, because actually teens, you know,
And they have to be to school at like 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning. So.
Right, and they have to be sitting at a desk, you know, in front of a chalkboard all day. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Sleep is a key. And, you know, as I mentioned, there's a whole bunch of other things that we do every day that make our ADHD worse. But, you know, the more we're aware of these things, the more we can go and learn and get on forums like Living with ADHD and express those and find out what other people are doing about them and do some research on them and start to wrestle them.
Yeah, I mean, just becoming educated and becoming aware of these things is a huge start. I mean, just some of these things are so simple you wouldn't even think that these are affecting ADHD and making it worse.
Absolutely. I mean, how many years was I eating a croissant for breakfast? It had to be four or 5 years before I finally came across some research that talked about the fact that different people have different metabolism types. And then I later, after my diagnosis, I learned that ADDers tend to have a protein-type metabolism, meaning that they can't do it with carbs. And there are some people in the world that can just live on simple carbs, and they'll be fine. But they have a different wiring than we do. And most ADDers,
I'm not one of them.
Protein. Yeah, I'm not either.
Mentally and physically, they don't agree with me. Okay, so with that, we are actually at towards the end of the show. Are there any final thoughts you'd like to leave people with today, Alan? And could you also give out your contact information once again?
You bet. I guess in sum, we ADDers have so many challenges and issues, and yet at the same time we have so much control at our disposal, you know? And we need to acknowledge this as we go out into the world and we're searching for solutions and we're engaged in forums and or listening to webinars on ADDClasses.com or wherever. And, you know, be more in touch with the things that you're doing and you have control over. And don't beat yourself up about it, but take a positive, proactive, and a hopeful approach to your exploration of solutions. And again, just kind of to remind folks of how to find our products and to find me. By the way, you can send me an email if you have questions at info@addcrusher.com if you have any specific questions about these. But come to our website, addcrusher.com. We've got a great blog there with a lot of information. Preview the videos there, and make sure you sign up for your free ebook, 5 Things You're Doing Every Day That Make Your ADHD Work, gives you a little bit more detail. And use the coupon code TARAMC for 15% off. And Tara, I just want to thank you again for having me on and for having this venue for people to listen to and help improve their lives.
Well, thank you so much, and thank you, everybody, for listening. And if you are listening to us on iTunes or Stitcher, be sure to stop by our website at www.ADHDsupporttalk.com. Thanks so much, and have a great day.
Bye-bye.
NAPA know-how.
NAPA guy knows not to judge a man by his car's multicolored paint job or absence of modern gadgetry. Who cares if it's technically old enough to vote and the windows are powered by the strength of your left arm? Your monthly payment is zero, and it'll stay that way. Because with over 500,000 parts and a little NAPA know-how, you can keep anything on the road. She may not be pretty, but she's all yours. That's NAPA Know How.
NAPA Know How.